If you ask Scarlett some questions about herself, you'll get some succinct answers, like how old are you?
4.
And what's your favorite part about school?
A playground.
Also, how would you describe the last few months of treatment?
Not very.
Though her answers are short, her journey has been long. Nearly 1 year ago, her family got the diagnosis.
She had a great Halloween, and then the next day the doctor here called me and told me that she had a positive biopsy, and they thought it was tested positive for leukemia, but she actually was not. It was lymphoma.
Her grandma, Dana Andrus, tells us they were blindsided.
We never were thinking it was cancer or anything like that. So you hear the news in one day, and then she was admitted that day. And they started chemo, I believe, the next day.
Little Scarlett was in the hospital for a week and underwent treatment on a weekly basis. Now there's reason to celebrate. She's in remission.
When it first started, she couldn't barely get out of bed because she was so sick from the chemo and everything. Now she's resumed going back to school, and she seems like a healthy four-year-old now. She's back with her best friend, her name is Zachy. Very excited. He's very excited to see her.
Most children survive their cancer diagnosis. We have a really high survival rate.
Dr. Lexa Walsh is a pediatric oncologist specializing in lymphoma and leukemia at Phoenix Children's Hospital.
Our treatments are really intensive, and they cause a lot of side effects.
Dr. Walsh says it's important to get the word out this month about childhood cancers, considering 300 new patients are diagnosed every year.
Raise money so that we're able to continue doing research, to continue to improve the cure rates.